Ian St. Clair, lead writer for PlayColorado.com. Welcome on the Business Brief.
Thank you for having me on, Ryan. I'm looking forward to talking some sports betting and the first year in Colorado.
I am as well, Ian. As you know, legal sports betting in Colorado just passed its one-year mark. Some might say its first birthday on May 1st. Between online sports betting and retail sports books, what a year it has been. Over $2 billion in sports bets in Colorado, nearly $130 million in gaming revenue, and over $10 million in state and federal taxes. Ian, what's your take on the first year, and how does this shape your view of the year ahead?
It was definitely a unique year to launch amidst a global pandemic and no major sports. And the fact that Colorado was still able to get $2 billion in handle is just nuts. It shows you what people have in sports betting, how excited they are to have it, what it means for the future, and why other states need to get on board with this. Our neighbors to the north in Wyoming are going to have legal sports betting probably around early to mid-September. So it shows you what the market is capable of. And the fact that the Denver Broncos weren't as good as anyone expects them or hopes them to be, and they're still able to get $2 billion for sports betting, it's just, it really is something that still blows my mind. I cover the industry, I've talked about this multiple times, and I still can't find the words to describe what this year did and what it means for the future. I think it just shows that the sky is the limit, or as I've joked, that the mile high altitude is going to be that high for sports betting in Colorado for the foreseeable future.
Absolutely. I have to be honest, this conversation feels like two kids in a candy shop, because you know I'm equally excited as you, as in terms of where it's going and the potential. You know, it excites me, and I'm really looking forward to what the year ahead offers Colorado and the country. Speaking of that excitement and that enthusiasm, Ian, enthusiasm around sports betting seems to only be accelerating. As you mentioned earlier, nationally, analysts at Goldman Sachs Research are forecasting a $39 billion online sports betting market in the U.S. by 2033. Representing one of the largest consumer growth opportunities over the next decade for our country, for that matter, in the world. What's behind this growth, and how might it shape our economy and the sports industry?
I think when you look at sports betting, it's a way to watch sports. It's another way to get engaged, because when you have money on the line, you feel like you're a part of it. So if you're betting on the Denver Broncos and you throw a couple of bucks down, and last season, the 2020 season, was probably the best one to do it, because more often than not, they were the underdog, whether it was against the money line or the spread bet, they were the underdog. So if you threw a couple of bucks down, you felt engaged. That's what happens regardless of the sport that you bet on, how you bet, you feel engaged. And it's another way to watch sports. It's an entertaining way to watch sports. And with how many opportunities there are to bet, if you look at the Colorado sports betting catalog, it's one of the reasons there are nearly 20 operators, around 20 operators in the state right now. It's because of that sports betting catalog and how extensive it is. So going forward, when you look at how the states are going to start setting this up, and I think one of the other reasons that it's so popular is Colorado, you can sign up for the app that you want to use from your couch. Unlike Nevada and Las Vegas, where you have to go to the brick and mortar casino to get the app, you can do that from your couch. I think that's another reason it's so popular. So I think you're going to start seeing mobile signups being something that states utilize, because they see what's going on in Nevada and Las Vegas, and they think, well, this is an opportunity that we can get to even more people. And I think with the promos, anyone watching this has seen the BetMGM commercials with Kenny Smith last year, and now Jamie Foxx. You see the DraftKings commercials, FanDuel, Bet Rivers, Points Bet with Allen Iverson. They're offering free money to bet. That's basically what it is. So I think all of those things just show you that sports betting is this booming industry that has only gotten started. I mean, PASPA, the Supreme Court ruling didn't get overruled until 2018. So it's only been not even 3 years. And we're already talking about a state in Colorado that got $2 billion in handle without major sports for most of the summer and launching during a pandemic.
Yeah, tons of demand there. And I think that says a lot. This is something people want. And that's important to remember. I agree with you, Ian. My perspective is it's a higher level of engagement. And I think that's one of the things that really is attractive and appealing to so many people. Okay, here's a question everyone wants to know, as it could have huge influence on the Denver Broncos Super Bowl chances, as well as just overall fan excitement and local business impacts. How are the sports betting markets reacting to the potential for Aaron Rodgers to leave Green Bay and come to Broncos country?
It's funny you mentioned that, Ryan. I did a story earlier this week at playcolorado.com on just the fact that a rumor has changed the Broncos Super Bowl odds, AFC odds, AFC West odds, and their over-under wins. Just from the rumor, it has catapulted those odds. At one point, at BetMGM and some of the younger sports books, it was at plus 6,600. As the rumor started to come out a couple hours before the draft, around an hour before the draft, when the Rodgers pandemonium started in Broncos country and fans thought maybe this could actually happen, you saw sportsbooks scramble to adjust their odds. FanDuel was at plus 5,000. The last I looked, it was 2,400. Just from a rumor. And FanDuel had it as high as 1,700. So just the rumor alone has just completely shifted how sportsbooks view the Denver Broncos, because they had some of the worst odds in the National Football League. 6,600 is not good odds to win the Super Bowl. So the fact that that rumor alone has shifted it shows you that if it does happen, they're going to be even better. Because one of the things that I mentioned in that piece at playcolorado.com is Pro Football Focus before the draft had the Broncos with the sixth best roster in the National Football League. So it shows you they're a quarterback away. If they get Aaron Rodgers to this offense with these weapons and that defense with Vic Fangio, the sky's the limit, just like sports betting here. The other thing that's interesting is in terms of the AFC and AFC West, the Broncos are now right behind the Cleveland Browns, a team that just went to the playoffs and a lot of people thought had a great draft. They're also ahead of the Chargers and the Raiders in the AFC West, and their over-under wins was at 7.5, and now it's at 9. Just off a rumor. That's how crazy it is. And it shows you that the sportsbooks wanted to prevent their loss, because they knew that people were going to jump on those odds as high as they were just from the rumor.
That's right. Well, and like you said, Ian, it's a rumor, but if it were to happen, it does greatly improve the Broncos' odds of actually not only going to the Super Bowl or to the playoffs, but to a Super Bowl and winning. And so that's exciting. And from an economic and business standpoint, I can tell you, it's just like, LeBron James coming to a city in L.A. or Cleveland. Everything kind of, benefits in terms of the economic impact, the local business impact, fans wanting to come out and be part of the experience. And so I don't know if it'll happen or not. I know it's still a rumor. There's a lot of talk about it, but certainly as a fan of the Broncos who wants to see the Broncos succeed, I'd love to see it happen. I'd love to see Aaron Rodgers make that move here. Ian St. Clair with PlayColorado.com. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks, Ryan.